how to bypass the BitLocker Recovery Screen. BitLocker is quite a powerful encryption software within Windows. It stands out because it keeps unauthorized users away from your information. However, sometimes seeing the BitLocker recovery sign on your screen is quite frustrating, especially when you forget the BitLocker recovery key for Windows. In this video, we'll look at different methods to bypass the BitLocker blue screen. Whether you've forgotten the BitLocker recovery key for Windows, or you just want to avoid seeing the screen the next time you turn on your computer, this video has got you covered. But before we go any further into how to fix the BitLocker problem, please like the video, subscribe to the channel, and leave a comment. Now, let's first see why the BitLocker recovery key is important. Part 1, causes of the BitLocker recovery screen. The BitLocker recovery key is a 48-digit number that becomes indispensable when the normal login options do not work, and you have to access the BitLocker protected drive. This default key generated during encryption serves as a backup so that you can always access your data. Here are some reasons why the BitLocker recovery screen appears on your computer. The most common reason for the BitLocker recovery screen on startup is when you repeatedly enter the wrong password. The new boot menu of Windows 10 also leads to the BitLocker recovery screen sometimes. Auto unlock, when turned on, can also cause the BitLocker problem in your computer. Issues such as outdated BIOS are also a common cause of the BitLocker recovery screen. Part 2. How to fix BitLocker recovery, Windows 11. So, how to bypass BitLocker without a recovery key and password? Here are some of the most effective ways to do that. Method 1, request and find a BitLocker recovery key. Now, the simplest solution to fix BitLocker recovery is finding your BitLocker recovery key. Now, if you don't remember it, try finding it before moving to other methods to fix the BitLocker problem. Here's where to look for the BitLocker recovery key. Log into your Microsoft account and check under Devices. If BitLocker was set up with your Microsoft account, the key should be listed there. If you saved the recovery key to a USB drive, attach that to your computer and look for a file named bitlockerrecoverykey.txt. Method 2, turn off the BitLocker feature using the command prompt. Now, if you're unable to find the BitLocker recovery key, then turning off the BitLocker feature using the command prompt might help. It's a simple process and doesn't require much time. Here's how you can do it. You can enable the command prompt from the BitLocker recovery screen to turn off BitLocker. On the BitLocker recovery screen, press the escape key for additional options. Now, click the Skip This Drive button. This will allow you to skip entering the recovery key here. You'll now be taken to a troubleshooting screen. Choose the Advanced Options link. Under Advanced Options, select the Command Prompt option. In the Command Prompt window, enter the manage-bde-unlockx-rp recovery_key command to unlock your encrypted drive. Replace X with the letter of your encrypted drive. Now, after running that command, once your drive is unlocked, turn off the BitLocker protection on the drive using the manage-bde-protectors-disablex.command. Again, replace X with your drive letter. This command will completely turn BitLocker off, which may allow you to access your drive normally. Now, close the command prompt window and restart your computer. You'll no longer see the BitLocker screen on startup. Method 3, turning on legacy boot to bypass the BitLocker recovery screen. Another effective method to resolve issues related to the BitLocker recovery screen is by turning on the legacy boot menu. Windows 11 BitLocker comes with a modern graphical boot menu, which can sometimes trigger BitLocker recovery issues. To fix the problem, you'll first need to open command prompt with admin access. You can easily do this by typing CMD in the search bar, finding the command prompt and right-clicking on it. Do remember to select the Run as Administrator from the drop-down menu. This will open the command prompt requesting permission to make changes to your system. with command prompt open, type the bcd edit /set brackets default boot menu policy legacy command and press enter. After you've run the command, close the command prompt and reboot your computer. Next time you turn on your computer, it won't show the BitLocker recovery key issue. Method 4, turning off auto unlock to prevent the BitLocker recovery screen. Sometimes the BitLocker screen on startup reappears due to the auto unlock feature that's already enabled. While auto unlock is designed for convenience, it can occasionally cause issues too. Turning off auto unlock can address the BitLocker problem and prevent the recovery screen from reappearing. Here's how. In the first step, open the control panel and click on System and Security. In the System and Security tab, click on BitLocker Drive Encryption. Under the BitLocker Drive Encryption settings, click Turn off auto unlock. This will prevent the auto unlock feature from accessing the encrypted drives. Method 5. Format the drive and reinstall Windows. Now, if you're still seeing the BitLocker recovery screen and other recovery methods don't help, formatting the drive and reinstalling Windows will fix the issue. Here's a step-by-step guide to do that. Open the command prompt. Type in list disk and press enter. This command will show you the list of disks on your system. Note down the drive letter of the disk you want to format. Let's refer to it as X. Type in the command, select disk X and press enter. Next, type list volume and press enter. It will show the volume of the selected disk. Take note of the volume number corresponding to your OS disk. Using the volume number of your OS disk, type select volume X, replacing X with your actual OS volume number. After you've done typing the command, press enter. Part 3, how to recover files after formatting drive. The methods discussed earlier may or may not work, but Wondershare Recover It will work 10 out of 10 times. Download and install the Wondershare Recover It software. Now, open it. Go to hard drives and locations, select the drive that you want to recover files from. You can filter the recoverable files with the help of search filters at the top of your screen. Click the Recover button at the bottom right, and Recover It will scan the target folder. After the scanning process, Recover It presents a list of files. You can browse this list and select the files that you want to recover. Once you've selected the desired files, you can save them to your computer. So, remember, BitLocker is a powerful tool for securing your data, but like any security measure, it requires careful management. By following the steps we've just highlighted here, you'll be able to troubleshoot and prevent problems from happening again. Now, if this tutorial was helpful, please give it a thumbs up to this video and subscribe to our channel for more tech tips and technology-related tutorials.